wrist band, sir. I debut in February. Representing the red corner, Justin Dowsett.
My career started taking off.
By Henry County Glass of Beer, and it will be held in the 150-pound weight class. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he is from Battle Creek, Michigan, fighting for Battle Creek Elite, Maximus Merciless Dudek! And fighting out of the red corner, he is from Connersville, Indiana. Tonight, he represents Subdue Combat Sports, Justin Destruction Dowsett! Referee for this contest will be Skylar Slay.
Here we go with the co-main event of the night, Justin Dowsett and Max Dudek.
Justin stepping in on 2 days' notice.
Oh, big outside leg kick from Justin.
Nice check hook there from Max.
Takedown attempt from Justin. Max stops it and gets on top here. Justin looking to slide those hips to the outside here. Max is trying to utilize heavy pressure right now. Up against the fence, trying to keep him smashed there. Justin doing a great job. Great hip movement from Justin. Avoiding punches.
Max looking to do some ground and pound.
He's in Justin's full guard now. Exchange of punches from the top and bottom. Right over here in front of us in the commentary section. Justin shifts his hip for an armbar here.
Wade used his feet against the cage there, and it looks like he might have an arm.
He's going to pull it out. Looking for maybe a own pot of position. Then Max gets out. Justin spins, goes for the takedown. Just couldn't get his weight shifted there.
Max stays on top of him.
Half guard position. Justin fights to get that full guard back.
Max in half guard here.
Back to full guard. Great job by Justin there. Max trying to gain more position. He's trying to posture up. Right back to his knees here. Justin's got a foot on hip.
Justin's placing his limbs right in the exact spot they need to be to nullify damage here, because Max is keeping top pressure on him pretty well.
Trying to soften him up from the bottom and then try to escape here. He's still got that foot on the hip. That's going to be big here.
Max showing strong hips there, too.
Yeah, he's very strong.
That foot on that hip, it's easy to get shoved backwards.
And that's what Max is aiming to do. He's just stacking up, trying to maintain position. Back to full guard. Justin puts the hip on the, or the foot on the hip again. And then he's gonna try to get out of here and escape. He wraps the leg up. That does trap your arm there. Oh, he's in triangle position now.
As the 10-second clap goes off. A little late offense from Justin Dowsett.
From the bottom position, hammer fist.
Probably the most significant strikes of the round there, those last five little hammer fists from bottom.
And once again tonight, we have been spoiled with grappling exchanges. I mean, we have seen some great back and forth on the ground tonight. And here we go with the 60-second intermission into the second round. Two of our co-main event of the evening. Good jabs thrown out there by Justin. Oh, some heavy strikes by Max. More heavy strikes.
A good flurry there from Max.
He's just letting them go.
Justin stays tight, but that's a lot of offense coming at him.
Justin fires back over the uppercut. Big strikes being thrown right now.
Looks like the corner Max told him to let the hands go a little bit more.
And he listened.
Ooh,
some more big punches from Max.
I think they both exchanged jabs there.
Max seems to be throwing combos every time he throws. Another
oh,
big
and a
uppercut.
Big uppercut there from Max.
Striking looks very solid out of Max tonight.
Good low kick there from Justin. Staying calm, staying composed. Very impressed with Max's stand-up, though. You are right. He's throwing punches by the three and fours almost every time.
Justin needs to catch him when he opens up. But Justin drops down for a takedown. He's got a leg.
And
a great takedown.
And he gets the single leg.
Trying to side control. He must be. Yep, he's going to maintain side control right now.
And they're ways away from the cage, it looks like. And Justin's going to try to turn and push him to the middle here.
He's going to switch to a guillotine.
Justin's known to have one of the best guillotines in the state.
He's locking it up. Oh, he let
it go.
They are going to be slippery. It's the second round. Very sweaty.
Good calm defense there by Max.
And they're right back to the ground where it was a good first round by Max. A lot of good exchanges on the ground, though.
And Max started this round off strong as well.
Justin looks for a Kimura here. Maybe to even help him get up. He got the leg over. Max does a great job turning to it, but Justin does a great job of adjusting.
Yep, and Max is very strong. You can tell he's just muscling through a lot of these submissions right now.
Oh, yeah. Justin had the arm, but he couldn't quite keep a hold of it there.
A little shake of the head of Justin, maybe disappointed in himself. He couldn't pull that one out.
Max is just very heavy on top. That seems to be the name of the game for this fight. Maintain heavy top pressure. We've seen that a few times tonight. The superior wrestler just gets top position. It's hard to shake him off. And we know Justin's one of the best at that.
Quick little flurry there from Max.
And 10-second clap there. Kind of similar second round to the first. A lot of top pressure.
A bit more striking to open up the round, but
absolutely.
Yeah, the round ended almost the same.
All right, we'll see how third round pans out of our co-main event of the evening. It's been a great fight so far. Here we go, round three of our co-main event of the evening. Starting on the feet again, obviously. That big outside leg kick. Good knee by Max on the inside. Justin drops and then right back to his back here. Not where he wants to be. See if Justin can get a better position this round. Try to shrimp and get out of there. Create a reversal opportunity.
And a stalemate here works in Max's favor. I think he might be up on the cards and he's just buying himself some time here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not much going on.
Well, just Max kind of staying in the half guard. Justin shrimps out a bit there. He's pushing him off the feet. Just can't quite get free.
Those little corner pads are quite a bit more difficult to wall walk than the cage is. Oh, and it looks
tight,
like a deep guillotine.
Tight guillotine, but
and he
gets
slips out.
He's just too slick right here in the third round, and Justin didn't have a full guard either there. Crowd calling for elbows, but I believe they're not allowed to throw elbows in amateur MMA.
Elbows to the body are allowed,
yes,
but elbows
yes.
to the head is probably what they're calling for, and we're not going to see any of that.
Thought about letting him up for a second, but then he just repositions.
Kind of use that leg to springboard himself
yep.
into position there.
Once again,
hard shots there.
This plays out in Max's favor. He seems to be up in this fight, and Justin can't seem to get off his back right now. Just crazy pressure from the top from Max. Justin's gonna. Once again, he does a good job. He just. Can't quite get away. There he goes. He shoots. He gets a takedown of his own. He has little time to work with, though. He's going to have to get to work quick.
Yeah, he's going to have to get busy. And it looks like Max is pretty polished on bottom as well. It's going to be difficult for Justin to make a move here.
Yeah, he's maintaining guard well. And there it is, the 10-second clap. Justin just goes for a big shot to end it.
One last attempt there from Justin.
Great fight out of these two gentlemen. I think the story of the fight was just top pressure from Max, but great exchanges from both gentlemen in this co-main event.
Yeah, that was a very technical fight. I wish we had that one for five rounds.
Yeah, that would have been a great five-round fight.
I'm impressed with what Max came with tonight, and And I'll be looking to see if they make that fight again, Skylar Reed and Max, because Skylar was the initial opponent, forced to pull out just days before the fight with a cut that he got in training. Like I said, just days before the fight, and he had to get stitches and was unable to fight tonight. But I'll be really interested to see if they make that fight happen now.
Yeah, I agree, Pete. That could be a great potential matchup, maybe a future title fight. I think this Max, I think his future is pretty bright. He looked great today in there against a vet of the scene.
Once again, another case of different divisions, but that's what you get it with amateur, and that's what you get with stepping in late. Justin normally fights. Although he's fought at 145, he hovers around 135 most of the time. So he's stepping up in weight tonight against a guy who says he weighs in at 160 on fight night. So a lot of heart from Justin, true veteran. This was his 21st bout. We'll go over to Brendan Evans to see what he has to say about it. Maximus comes away with the win there, getting his second MMA win of the night. We want to go over to the 50-50, and then we will be on for the main event of the night, Damian Sexton versus Cole Trajanstein.